from the quarterback, and he fakes it and gives it instead to Tony Jeffrey, touchdown. Oh, I thought Ankrum had kept the ball for himself. It seemed like he kept it in Jeffrey's stomach forever. And then Ankrum just laid it in there, and Jeffrey saw the hole and went in untouched for the score. Fake to Bednarski, give Tony Jeffrey, 35, 30-yard line, breaks a tackle, 25, 20 down the sideline to the 10, to the 5, and he is in! Touchdown! TCU, Tony Jeffrey from 38 yards away. Here is Rasko, a give right to Bobby Davis, faked it to Davis, and here's Jeffrey again down the right sideline, breaks a tackle, 35, 40, 45, midfield, great block, Delaney, Jeffrey at the 35, you can say goodbye, people, he's gone. Touchdown, TCU, Tony Jeffrey, 82 yards.
Hello, this is a Tony Jeffrey show, and your host is Jim Wacker, the football coach at TCU. Folks, it was a fun football game, I'll tell you that. The Horned Frogs exploded against Tulane. But the guy that really exploded, the guy who ran for more yards than any back in the history of the Southwest Conference in one game, Tony Jeffries, 343 yards rushing. That's an incredible story. And we are still kind of in shock. I still can't believe it this morning after I woke up. You know, it's just one of those kind of a days. But, man, what an incredible, incredible day the young man had. But, you know, looking back on the game, hey, we struggled a little bit in the first half. We definitely gave up more passing yardage than we would have liked to, but boy, all of a sudden in the second half, defense came out, played tremendous in the third quarter. Offense put it together. We scored three or four touchdowns. Tony started running up and down the field, scoring on all those long runs. And man, it was just a fun, fun day. Now, let's go ahead and let's zero in and let's take a look at a back having the best day of any running back that I've ever seen in my entire life. Jeffries, 343 yards. Tony, that's unbelievable.
It was unbelievable, Coach. I'm still shocked from it.
We all are, baby. We all are. That was an incredible day, I'll tell you. What do you think the key was?
The key was the offensive lineman, Coach.
Offensive lineman, them skinny guys?
Big guy.
You mean guys like Jeff Hopkins and Mike Buller and Clint Haley and W.C. Nixon and Brian Brazel? What a job they did.
Yeah, we had a good time.
My side.
Hey, my side.
My side.
Oh, okay, man. Okay, man.
Like I was saying, Tony Jeffries had one fantabulous day. And man alive, no one would have ever guessed it. You know, you take a look, we had two freshmen redshirts starting in the offensive line. We had two or three other key backs that are out with injuries. We had quarterbacks that are banged up. And David Rasko, after coming off the tough, tough year he did a year ago, boy, you know, he had to go out there, and he wasn't sure how he'd perform, and neither was anyone else. And he executed the wishbone and the veer about as well as you can execute it. And you know, what really makes it special, we go over 500 yards rushing in a single game. That is a new school record. Tony Jeffrey scores 5 touchdowns. That's a new school record. And, single game rushing record once again for an individual in one particular day. Boy, those are things you can really get excited about.
And they come out in the wishbone. So it hasn't taken very long for Jim Wacker to decide to go to the bone. The up back is Roscoe Tatum, but they give it to Bobby Davis across the 20, across the 25, and he's out to the 26-yard line. So
Bobby Davis. First and 10.
TCU at the 43-yard line. They go to the veer this time after running the initial set out of the wishbone to give to Bobby Davis, and Bobby Davis gets down to the 35-yard line. Preston.
This is stopped by number 40.
Backs are in tight but split behind Rasko, who rolls out to the right side with a lot of time to throw. Has a man, Jared Delaney, across the Tulane 30 at the 27-yard line. Thurston Harrison. Wishbone set. Here is Rasko. Belly fake to the fullback. Give to Bobby Davis. Scatters his way through the middle of the line, 50, and into Tulane territory at the 44-yard line. Wishbone set this time with Bednarski as the fullback. And here is Rasko. Hits Bobby Davis, runs the left side, tries to turn it up across the 45, out near midfield. But a flag. 70. A minute five to play. Rasko, option left side. He's going to keep it. 15, 10, 5-yard line. Rasko, tightrope, touchdown. Or give up the middle. Scott Bednarski across the Tulane 45 and down to the 41-yard line. First and 10, 41-yard line of Tulane. Here is Rasko. Give up the middle. And this is Bednarski once again breaking tackles along the way. Preston Washington.
What was really encouraging was to see a lot of new faces in the lineup. Guys like Jeff Hopkins and Mike Bull and Scott Bednarski. Man alive, there are a lot of players playing with a lot of dedication, a lot of commitment. But there's one reason this football team in 1986 is more committed than any other. And it happens to be that decal, that number 50, that every player is wearing on their helmet.
Keep that dream to play pro ball one day. And I just can't help think about it. You know, when he came in, he was maybe, 215 pounds, 220 pounds. I mean, like Coach said, man, he was probably one of the best linemen we've had. He was a close friend to me. And, you know, a lot of us don't realize, and I think because of his death, I've grown up a lot. I came in here as a spoiled kid. Everything came easy to me. And when Keith died, I finally realized, man, life's for real. It ain't no game. And the thing Keith really taught me, and the thing that I learned most out of this, is that I come out here every day and I practice like it's my last. Because, you know, when I said bye to Keith on December, after our final, we took our last final together, you know, and I talked to him that day before he died, about 6 hours before he died, I talked to him. And I had no idea that I'd never see him again. And I just want you all to know that I still haven't said goodbye to Keith. You know, every night I get on my knees and pray to God and talk to Keith. And I know if Keith was here, he'd tell y'all one thing. Just play every day like it's your last, because we don't know when we're gonna go, none of us.
I don't need to say anything about what kind of person Keith was, because most of us here knew him. But I'm real glad that we're going to make this dedication. But that kind of puts a commitment before us. If we're going to dedicate this year to Keith, we need to make sure it's a year worth dedicating. And I just want to make sure all y'all realize that.